Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This video here will show the preparation and changes for the Csec Visual Arts Examination 2021. So let's fly on into it. Artwork fly.
Artwork fly.
It is my pleasure now to invite or to introduce the person that will be introducing the guest speaker this morning. And that's the lady that you've been hearing so much about, who has led the team to make this art conference 2021 possible. Ladies and gentlemen, it is none other than Mrs. Loni Palmer Carroll, Visual Arts Education Officer in the MOEYI Region 5 office. And she will be introducing our keynote speaker this morning. Mrs. Palmer Carroll, are you there?
I am here. Good morning. Edward Manet states, and I quote, "It's not enough to know your craft. You have to have feeling. Science is all very well, but for us, imagination is worth far more." Our presenter has a passion for visual arts and curriculum development. He completed his studies at the University of the West Indies, where he holds a teacher's diploma, a bachelor's of arts degree, a master's of education in curriculum development, and a graduate diploma in education administration. He has over 20 years experience in the classroom, where he served as HOD, head of department, for 11 years. Within the past 20 years, he worked with CXC in the capacity of examiner, assistant examiner, assistant chief examiner, and chief examiner for moderation for both CSET Visual Arts and CAPE Art and Design. He's a workshop facilitator, a panel and syllabus review committee member for CSET Visual Arts. Currently, he is the Visual Arts Curriculum Officer in the Ministry of Education in Trinidad and Tobago. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome our presenter, no other than Mr. Reynald Ramlogan. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ms. Palmer. On the theme of our session, a theme that is quite fitting in terms of the requirements and how we intend to go forward and address our CSEC Visual Arts exam. What are we to prepare as we go forward for this 2021 Visual Arts session? If you would allow me to share my screen. So are you all seeing the screen there? So this morning, my intention really is to go through some of the changes that would be required for our examination this year, and we will discuss some methods of preparation. I would also do a section of the presentation that will be devoted to the reflective journal and what is expected of the reflective journal. We would also talk about exam and how we approach the exam for both teachers and students. So for visual arts, at the CSEC level, our general requirements would be students must select two expressive forms. These are things that we know, and I just want to spend some time reviewing them. Students must complete three SBA pieces for each expressive form. They must also compile a reflective journal in terms of documenting their research and the production of artworks in each expressive form. The reflective journal must show the process and production of 5 samples for each expressive form study. And the students must also complete their production exam for each expressive form. So these are normal requirements under normal conditions. what will be expected for 2021. So in 2021, the major difference is that students will be required to submit 2 SBA pieces per expressive form instead of 3 pieces. So they are doing both expressive forms, but instead of submitting 3 SBA pieces for each, they would now be required to submit 2 SBA pieces. There has been some changes as well that I missed in terms of updating here. But for the journal, the reflective journal, instead of students submitting 5 samples per expressive form, they will be required to submit 3 samples per expressive form. All right, so that is the major change with respect to our CSEC visual arts examination. All right, so in a nutshell, what we are doing, you are submitting 2 SBA pieces per expressive form. In your journals, you are submitting 3 samples per expressive form to give you a total of 6. I will just quickly touch on CAPE. And in CAPE, we know that we have our research unit 1, our research paper. Unit module 2, 3 SBA pieces in the 2-dimensional realm. Module 3, 3 SBA pieces in the 3-dimensional realm. We also have our multiple choice questions and a production paper based on module 1 and module 3. Module 2 and module 3. The changes for that is that in module 2, where students would have originally submitted 3 SBA pieces, they are now required to submit 2 SBA pieces. And the same would apply for module 3. They will be required to submit 2 SBA pieces instead of the 3 SBA pieces in the 3-dimensional option. So instead of submitting 6 pieces for the module between module 1 and module 2 and 3, they will be submitting 4 pieces. For unit 2, again, the general requirements is that they are to submit 1 2D and 1 3D piece for the design module, which is module 1. A similar approach for module 2, which is the applied arts module, and the creative project. The changes will come in module 2. So module 1, they are still required to submit 2 pieces, 1 2D, 1 3D. And module 2, they will be required to submit 1 2D or 1 3D piece. They are not required to submit both. They are required to submit either the 2D piece or the 3D piece. Everything else remains the same.
Please remember to like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit the bell so you can always know when I upload.